You mentioned dairy products, and I made a little bit of a list here of things that I don't like about dairy products. I'll just go over it briefly. The casein, the major protein in dairy products, makes about 85% of the protein, is one of the strongest cancer promoters in the world. Antibiotics are a common contaminant of dairy products, perhaps not organic, but all of the others. Then there's endotoxins, those dead bacterial shells that trigger inflammation throughout the body in arthritis and in the brain. Then there's advanced glycation end products that form when cheese is aged, and these go into the brain and shower it with free radicals, destroying brain cells. Then there's the bioaccumulation of persistent organic pollutants like organochlorines and polychlorinated biphenyls. Then there's the thing about mucus. The beta-casomorphin 7, an addictive chemical in dairy products, creates more mucus. It actually creates more mucus cells, and they produce more and thicker mucus. As any of us know who don't eat dairy, if we're ever exposed to it, it creates this real gunky stuff. Then there's constipation. Common with any opiate, and the beta-casomorphine in dairy products creates constipation. I think it plugs people up much more than any other food. Then there's the increased prostate and breast cancer, tons of studies on this. Then there's the type 1 diabetes. It seems that the dairy triggers the death of the beta cells, especially in young people. There's also the fact that autism often reacts to the withdrawal of dairy. About 50% of autistic kids improve their behavior dramatically when dairy is removed. Then there's the phthalates, like bisphenol A, that get into the dairy from those tubes in the dairy. And this is a nasty hormone chemical that would be good not to have. Not to mention insulin-like growth factor 1, which is identical in cows and humans and promotes cancer. Then there's the recombinant bovine growth hormone, which they clip onto the cow's ears. This is a genetically modified hormone that gets into the dairy products and into humans. And of course, the high saturated fats of dairy products contribute to many diseases like heart disease, stroke, and diabetes, and of course, Alzheimer's disease and via vascular dementia. The extra estrogen in dairy products is a problem, and this is common because they keep the cows pregnant. Then there's the insulin resistance that is induced by dairy products. I won't mention new 5GC, anyway, and trans fats, which did you know that dairy cows create trans fats in their rumen through a biohydrogenation process, and that some people get as many trans fatty acids from dairy as they do from industrial produced oils. I just wanted to regale you with some good reasons to avoid this highly addictive substance. Thank you for listening.
That's a guy.